Hi, this is From A to Vegan, and I'm Chris, and today I'm with food blogger and author of vegan and gluten-free food cookbooks and artist and photographer, Allyson Kramer.
Thanks. Hi, it's great to be here.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah.
Thanks definitely. For having lunch with us.
It was delicious.
We're here in New Hope, PA, and we love coming here, and Allyson is fairly local. She's another Pennsylvania person, so we're so excited to actually see you and expand, you know, the vegan circle around this area.
Yeah, me too. It's lovely meeting you guys here today. So
I know.
Quick drive from Philly.
It's a little rainy, but you know, it's not too bad today. That's what you expect in the summertime.
It's okay, yeah.
So first I wanted to ask you about your journey and how you became vegan, because a lot of people want to know how people have gotten to this point in their lives.
Yeah, well, it's kind of a long journey. I started when I was maybe 13, 14-ish, researching vegetarianism because my sister was really into it and I used to eat out with her a lot. And so I got kind of interested in it that way. Started cooking a lot from the vegetarian cookbooks because I'd been cooking a lot, not from vegetarian cookbooks. And from there I started realizing a lot of recipes didn't have any animal products in them. And it kind of got me interested in veganism. So I started to seek out more resources on that. And there weren't very many at the time. But what I could find, I loved it and I got really fascinated with it. So I just right then became vegan. And you know, I was a teenager, so I had to do all the cooking for myself. And my parents were like, you're not going to be very healthy. And that lasted for a couple years. It was really great. And then off and on, you know, peer pressure, other things would come up. And so I would kind of slip in and out of veganism for maybe a month. I wouldn't be vegan. Then I'd go back. And that went on and off again until I got out of college, honestly. And then I was like, you know, all this stuff that I thought about veganism, I really believe it, and I started, there was much more information out there at the time, so I fully embraced it, and I haven't gone back since.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, and then you had a health scare, and you did all this research and figured out that gluten-free was the way that you wanted to go.
Yeah, more or less. I mean, I was kind of researching alongside of my doctors. They were giving me the blood tests and all the other routine things, and nobody had any answers for me, so I just felt bad. I felt really, really bad. So I started reading a lot of blogs and stuff, and the one, Choosing Raw, which is mostly raw, high raw blog by Jenna Hamshaw. I love her blog. I had just happened upon it, and I thought, you know, everyone's doing all these health claims with raw food, and maybe this would work for me. I can't feel any worse at this point. So I gave it a shot, and I immediately felt better, and I thought it was the raw food at the time until I went back to my doctor and we confirmed that it was celiac disease, in fact. So it was kind of like a coincidence, but me confirming to my doctor, to her, and the person that gave me the diagnosis that I've actually been off of gluten for 20 days and I feel fabulous, which is opposed to how horrible I felt for 5 years, that combined with the blood tests and the other results is how I kind of got there. And I have not felt bad since.
It's an incredible journey. If you haven't read about what happened to Allyson, you really should. It's on your blog, manifestvegan.com.
How I became a gluten-free vegan.
And it was very moving, so I wanted to ask you about that. It was moving to me, and
Thank you.
Don't have to worry about that kind of stuff, but it's always interesting to see how people can really change their lives for themselves and, you know, really do it for yourself.
It felt very empowering.
Yeah.
I felt so sick, and then it was like, you know, I don't feel bad anymore, and it was just a simple switch. Obviously, I didn't know that at the time, but once I figured it out, it was a really easy solution. So.
And I wanted to ask you about your food photography, because you're very good at it.
Thank you.
I love your pictures. And do you think that helps when you have gluten-free to be able to show people how gorgeous and delicious it can look like
to help
to bring them in so they could try your recipes?
Yeah, I think it's very important, in fact, because I think most people have misconceptions about gluten-free food and vegan food, that it's going to look different, that it's going to taste weird, that it's all going to be brown and, you know, not very palatable, you know, cardboard is what a lot of people think of. So I think the pictures are very important to illustrate. This is what, I mean, I make the recipe exactly as I make it, and then I shoot immediately after, and then I eat it. So it's exactly what you're going to be getting when you make the recipe yourself. And I don't think a lot of people would try it because they might see like a donut recipe or something and be like, oh yeah, but I've had gluten-free donuts in the past and they've been kind of crumbly or dry. I try to show with, like, you know, even macro shots that there's moist, there's a nice crumb to this. It's tasty.
Right? See, that's what we were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
And I saw the picture of yours and now I want to try it again. So that's a good thing.
Right. Yes.
See? So that helps
then
me.
Then it worked.
It worked. It worked for me. I'm very, you know, obviously that's different for me.
Yeah.
And I was also saying to you that I love the fondant. I was so excited to see that fondant recipe that you have on your blog.
Yay.
And that you can actually make it vegan and gluten-free.
Right.
Was just so cool to me. And
right.
You seem to got a lot of good positive responses from
yes.
it.
And from the people that have made it. They've really enjoyed it.
So,
well, so
you just decided one day that you wanted to make it and you went out and figured out
yep.
how to make it and you did it.
Exactly.
That's inspiring.
And with all
me.
The vegan products like the dandy marshmallows that are available, it makes veganizing things so easy. So
and it looks delicious.
Yeah.
You paired it with that cake.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, for Valentine's Day. It was
yeah.
so pretty. I'm
it
gonna have
delicious.
To make that. It looks so delicious. Now before we get rained on some more, before we're completely drenched.
It's sunny.
You have yeah, I know. At least it's sunny. You have a lot of things coming up.
Mm-hmm.
We're excited to see you at Bethlehem Veg Fest,
yes.
which is in September.
Yep.
It's September 8th.
Yep, I'll be there at 3 p.m. doing a cooking demo.
Do a cooking demo. And you have a new book out right now.
Yes, I have Great Gluten-Free Vegan Eats is my first book that I've written. And then I have a follow-up book coming out next summer, Great Gluten-Free Vegan Eats Gone Global. So
wow. So we have a lot to look forward
yeah.
to from you. We're so glad that you met us here.
Yes.
And we can't wait to see more of what you do in the future.
Thank you so much.